Greetings. If you are Muslim, I encourage you to watch this whole video to gain understanding. Thank you, Brother Zheng, for your lengthy comment. I'm going to read it all first, then address it and several other points. Jesus denied being good in the sense that God is good. If Jesus is God, one would expect him to admit he is good in the sense that God is good, meaning perfect. Here are the passages, Matthew 19:16, "And behold, one came and said unto him, Good Master, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life? Verse 17, "And when he said unto him, Why call you me good? There is none good but one, that is God. But if you will enter into life, keep the commandments." So note, the man calls Jesus good, and Jesus tells the man there is none good but God. Obviously, Jesus referred to God as someone else, which also proves Jesus isn't God. However, the main importance of the passages is that Jesus denies being good in the way God is good, which is to be perfect. I'd like to begin, brother, by reviewing this story, which is described in three of the Gospels, in Matthew, Mark, and Luke. Before I begin with Matthew, I need to address one discovery. There are two flavors of possible meanings which this story seems to imply, represented by two very different statements. Did the man call Jesus good, or did the man ask Jesus about doing good? As I dug into the Greek to answer your question, brother, I was a little taken by both meanings being presented. Let's look first at Matthew's rendition of this exchange. Examining your quote, I believe you have referenced the King James translation. "And behold, one came and said unto him, Good Master, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life?" And there we see "good master" as you cited. We also see "what good thing." The Bible teaches us to study, brother, to dig for understanding. So I always read more than one translation. The English Standard: "And behold, a man came up to him, saying, Teacher, what good deed must I do?" I immediately noticed this does not call Jesus good. The Berean Study Bible: "Just then a man came up to Jesus and inquired, Teacher, what good thing must I do?" Again, this does not call Jesus good, only teacher. New American Standard Bible: "And someone came to him and said, Teacher, what good thing shall I do?" Wow, 3 for 3. This does not call Jesus good, only teacher. And I looked at 24 English translations of the Bible, and 9 translations include "good teacher, what good thing shall I do?" And honestly, brother, this seemed a mystery, and those always get my interest going. Using "good" in 2 places implies both of the meanings I mentioned earlier. Did the man call Jesus good, or did the man ask Jesus about doing good? The only way to gain understanding is to look at the original Greek, which we have to this day. We have whole manuscripts from before Muhammad confirmed them, brother. So here is the original Greek. And there is only one usage of the term "good" in Matthew 19:16. "Teacher, what good thing shall I do?" And in this examination, it seems to ask, "what good thing?" But brother, I am not through digging yet, and I will address your topic. I mentioned this story was recorded in Mark and Luke as well. The Berean Study Bible: "Then a certain ruler asked him, Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" Ah, first one examined says, "good teacher." In fact, all of the 24 English translations of the Bible, they all say "good teacher." Still, to be a good Berean, I examined the Greek as well for Luke 18:18. And here we can see "good" modifies "teacher," not "what having done." So clearly Luke records that Jesus was called good by the young ruler. And in the Gospel of Mark 10:17, the third record of this event also includes the detail of good master. So let's go back to your statement, which is dripping with assumption, brother. Jesus denied being good in the sense that God is good. The first assumption you make, brother, is that Jesus did not speak directly or actively. To clarify, you are assuming Jesus meant something other than what he actually said. I'll get back to that more in a moment. If Jesus is God, one would expect him to admit he is good in the sense that God is good, meaning perfect. This is a second assumption, brother, that God is required to behave as your human thinking dictates or assumes. But God is not bound by human insecurities or human limitations. Nor is God obligated to reveal anything except what God's plan to reveal includes. You then cited Matthew 19:16 and verse 17. I believe from the King James, but certainly one that includes good teacher. So note, the man calls Jesus good. Jesus tells the man there is none good but God. And I believe this element of your comment reveals an oversight, brother. I do not think it is intentional of you, brother, simply agenda blindness. Islam has taught you so you see things a certain way, to make things fit the Islamic narrative. Jesus asked a question that you skipped right over, brother. Jesus asked, "Why do you call me good?" Pay close attention to that fact, brother. I believe the question is critical to the truth of the encounter. Jesus asked the man a question, "Why do you call me good?" The question is critical because it challenges the man. It goes right into the heart of the man to test if he is serious or not. And brother, it has an exact parallel with what Jesus also asked his disciples who followed him. Matthew 16:19, he said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter answered, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." "Why do you call me good? Who do you say that I am?" "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." So this was what Peter answered. And Jesus had an opportunity to challenge or correct any excess in religion in Peter's statement. Instead, Jesus said the following. And Jesus said to him, "Blessed are you, Simon Barjona, because flesh and blood did not reveal this to you, but my Father who is in heaven." Right there, brother, in black and white, Peter calls Jesus the Son of God. And Jesus honored and praised Peter's statement. Jesus says God gave Peter this revelation. Now, we know the title Son of God carried meaning of equality with God. Because when Jesus said he was the Son of God, the Jews took up stones to kill Jesus. John 10:33, the Jews answered him, "For a good work we do not stone you, but for blasphemy, and because you, being a man, make yourself out to be God." Later, talking back to them, Jesus said, "Do you say of him whom the Father sanctified and sent into the world, 'You are blaspheming because I said I am the Son of God'?" Getting back to the young ruler, Jesus asked him a question. "Why do you call me good?" And just to give the man food for thought, Jesus added, "Only God is good." Essentially, Jesus said, "You call me good, and only God is good." Maybe Jesus was really asking the man a more pointed question. Are you with knowledge and intent calling me God? I am not saying that is absolutely the intent of Jesus with his question. But please pay attention to one critical aspect of the text, brother. At no point did Jesus say the words, I am not God. I know you want to see and imagine those words. You want to invent those words to fit the fables of Islam. But those words do not exist, brother. So what was the right answer? What should the man have answered? Before answering that, brother, it is interesting to note that Jesus invited this man to be one of his disciples. I think I was shocked the first time somebody said that or pointed that out to me. Luke 18:22. On hearing this, Jesus told him, "You still lack one thing. Sell everything you own and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come, follow me." Mark 10:21. Jesus looked at him, loved him, and said to him, "There is one thing you lack. Go, sell everything you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come, follow me." That is a clear invitation given to this man just like the other disciples. I think Jesus knew the response before asking it. So what should the rich young ruler have said when challenged by Jesus? "Why do you call me good?" Jesus asked him. "Nobody is good except for one, God." The rich young ruler should have said, "I call you good because I believe you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. I call you good because I believe you are the prophet, foretold by Prophet Moses, Prophet Elijah, Prophet Malachi, and Prophet John. You are the mighty God, as foretold by Prophet Isaiah. You are Emmanuel, God with us, born of the Virgin, as Prophet Isaiah foretold. You are the fulfillment of Prophet Malachi, God come in the flesh to his temple. And you have come as a prophet, as prophets Malachi and Moses foretold. So I worship you, O God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I fall at your feet and worship the God of heaven and earth, come in the flesh, as you said you would." Brother, if the rich young ruler had said this, Jesus would have had a 13th disciple, because Jesus had invited him to follow him with the other 12. But the rich young ruler loved his money more than God. And I believe followers of Muhammad love Muhammad more than God. And this convinces you to reject the invitation to follow the one true God who is good. You reject the God of the prophets, the God who came in the flesh just as he said he would. May your heart cry out to God for his truth, brother. May you long to know what the prophets have really said, brother. Jesus did not say, "I am not God." May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.